Hello, my name is Carsten Hansen. I have done a few videos to demonstrate you the functionality of the lip sync feature in our audio and video instrument. But first of all, just to give you a quick look at idea of what we're looking at. We are looking at the HDMI output of the DKT7 audio and video analyzer. And the signal we are looking at is coming from a PTO5300 test generator that we have. I can show you if I click here, you can see this is the picture we are looking at. So the picture is what we call a clapboard picture, and the picture takes 2 seconds to repeat. And every 2 seconds when this curtain closes, it will give out a white flash, and it will give you an audio tone at the same time. This is a click. Currently you are listening to my voice, but I can change this quickly. So you can hear, actually, if I put the embedded signal to the output. So in the right-hand channel, you have the click. Yeah, this is a click. I put my voice back in both channels again. So now I'm back in both channels. So the picture, you can also see it has a text information, DK Technologies, and you can see that text information is encoded to 75% video luminance, and the white flash is 100% luminance. This is a very distinct, you can say, fingerprint. And the software inside this unit, because it contains both audio and video, is able to calculate the timing difference between the white flash and the click. So if I roll back here and put the lip sync function on, you can see I have this tiny display. This is currently showing you 1 or 0, and that actually means that it's 100% aligned. Our test pattern is generated the way that the click will sit right in the middle of the picture. The picture we are looking at is encoded, as you can see, it's a 720 50 hertz encoded progressive. So that means that each frame will take 20 milliseconds. And the click is aligned, so the click is sitting right in the middle of the picture. So when I read 0 here, means actually 10 milliseconds. So that varies from system to system, but it's always sitting in the middle. Now, if I try to change, I have to move a little, so bear me with the audio. To change the timing, I can adjust that. So I roll this to 100 milliseconds. Now I'm 60, let's say 91. Okay, now I have rolled the generator to offset the timing 100 milliseconds. So now the audio is offset 100 milliseconds from the, I know it's a little difficult to see on this capture because you also have some latencies, but you have to believe me. You can see the digits, and it's corresponding exactly to the offset that I have programmed. You will always have a small variation because we will have a resolution of 1 millisecond in the calculation here. So that means it will alter between these two numbers. But you have to consider what number you're trying to trace. You're trying to track down numbers that are multiple frames, and certainly not 1 millisecond. The travel in free space of air between, you know, the top and the bottom is something like 5 meters. So 1 millisecond has no, it's correspond to just a meter or so. Doesn't matter. Okay, I don't know if you're able to hear it, but I can switch back so you can see to the right-hand channel, so I can put the click. And you can see that there's a timing difference between now between the audio and the video. I switch the audio back. Okay, this is test condition. And of course, this is interesting to see. This is something you can use in a permanent installation when you want to track out how good your systems are aligned. But the real thing is that once you start to record it, as I'm doing here, you will have the playback system and the recording system, the capture and the timing difference between audio and video. And that will be the next part, because I have recorded this on my Macintosh, and I will try to demonstrate you to play it back with different players, both compressed and uncompressed. And I can also show you when I'm using my internal flash disk, which is extremely fast on the Mac, or I'm using a Thunderbolt external disk. And you can see all these changes give me a different timing. So the timing is pretty inaccurate once you record it. But that will be on the next. So a small break here.